In this video, I'd like to take a look at Lewis structures, which are a way of representing chemical compounds that can be really useful to us. What Lewis structures do is they take a three-dimensional object, a molecule, and they represent it in 2D. So paper is flat, so Lewis structures are flat. And this is an example over here of a Lewis structure. What can I tell from it? Well, I can show relatively where the atoms are. This nitrogen is next to this carbon, is next to this carbon, and here's where the oxygens are. I can know where the atoms are. I can also know the number of bonds, so I can see that there are bonds around the molecule. Not only can I tell the number of bonds, though, but I can also tell what's called their order. And so bond orders, you can say 1, 2, or 3, right? You number them. There are half bond orders, like 1.5 or 2 1/3 or things like that. We'll get to that later. Excuse me. But bond orders are how many electrons are involved. And so this single lines that I've highlighted, those are bond order 1, and I call them single bonds, and every line involves 2 electrons. On the other hand, something like this right here, there are 2 lines connecting this carbon and this oxygen. So we call that a double bond. And since each line represents 2 electrons, a double bond involves 4 electrons. Third, and I'm going to have to draw a different molecule for this, I'm going to give you carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide has the atoms connected by 3 lines. And by the way, there are dots here on each end. That bond of 3 lines has a bond order of 3. It's called a triple bond. And you guessed it, it involves 6 electrons. A last thing that Lewis structures tell us are the distributions of lone pairs. And lone pairs are unshared electrons. So these 2 electrons right here, this is a lone pair. So this nitrogen appears to have 1 pair of electrons all to itself. These oxygens, on the other hand, each keep 2 pairs of electrons to themselves. So each oxygen has 2 lone pairs on it. Those are things I can tell from a Lewis structure. Where the atoms are, what kinds of bonds connect them, right? That's this part. And then whether any of the atoms are hogging electrons to themselves as lone pairs. What I can't tell is I can't tell whether this molecule over here has a particular 3D shape or not. Real molecules are not flat. Paper is flat, so Lewis structures are flat. But the real molecule does not look like this. And so I need some different stuff later. But let's start by learning how to draw Lewis structures. We're going to look at our rules for Lewis structures in the context of the structure of methane. And the first thing that I do when I work on a Lewis structure is I want to count up the valence electrons. So yes, I know that carbon is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Remember that these 4 are the valence electrons. So carbon, when I list it out, and then I'll make a list for my hydrogens as well, has 4 valence electrons. Shortcut, use the column of the periodic table. Group 1 has 1 valence. Group 2 has 2 valence. We skip over, right? So there's 1 and 2. We skip over the transition metals. 3 valence electrons, 4 valence electrons, 5 valence electrons, and then 6, 7, 8, right? The column tells you the column tells you how many valence electrons it has. Carbon lives here, so it has 4. Hydrogen lives here. And so hydrogen has 1, but there are 4 of them. So I'm going to put a 4 times 1. So I have 8 electrons to count up by the time I am all said and done here. Going on, what I want to do is I want to put the least electronegative element in the middle of my molecule. And there is an exception to that. And that's hydrogen. Hydrogen will never, ever, ever, ever go on the inside of a molecule. Hydrogen is always on the outside. Another rule of thumb that works, I'd say 95% of the time, is that if you can make the structure symmetrical, you should do it. And so all of those things together, the fact that hydrogens never go on the outside, carbon's not super electronegative, and I should look for symmetry, says I'm going to put the carbon in the middle, and I'm going to line up 4 hydrogens around it. All right, I've put the atoms relative to one another, but what I have to do now is I have to distribute bonds. And the way we're going to start is always with one bond per pair. So let's put everybody as single bonds. And then what we do is we count up. So I, by doing 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, by making 4 bonds, have given away 8 electrons. Remember, every bond has, every line represents 2 electrons. I've given them all away. I'm out of electrons. I have no more to give away. Going on, if there are some to give away, we start giving away what are called the lone pairs, right? We give those lone pairs to, well, that makes sense. We give them to the electron hogs, the elements that are closest to fluorine, right? Things that like electrons, we give them. And we work downward until we run out of electrons. Eventually, we run out of electrons to give away. And you'll see this in 2 more examples in a moment. Lastly, though, right? So 4 is an intermediate step, right? I didn't have to do it here because I have no electrons left. 5, we always want to do. It's called an octet check. Octet, of course, equals 8. And so does everybody touch 8 electrons? And here is an exception that you want to know. H should touch 2. And so I count. In my structure, this hydrogen touches a line, so it touches 2 electrons. Each hydrogen is exactly like that. They each touch 2 electrons. What about carbon? Carbon touches 2, 4, 6, 8. So we're all good. If the octet's fine, you can keep going. And since my octets were fine and I gave away all my electrons, I can go ahead and clean up my structure. Let's make it look better so that when somebody's reading it, they can tell. All right, let's try this on a couple more structures. Let's try NCl3. When I look at NCl3, I know that nitrogen has 5 valence electrons from the periodic table. It's in group 5. And I know that there are 3 chlorines. Chlorine's in group 7, so there's 7 of them. And 3 because there's 3 chlorines. So I see 21 plus 5. When I'm said and done, I should have 26 electrons. That's rule 1. Rule 2, let's get the least electronegative element in the center. Nitrogen is farther away from fluorine, so it's less electronegative. Nitrogen lives inside, and chlorines go around the outside. Distribute single bonds. I've given away 6. I still have 20 more to go. So now I start distributing to the most electronegative element. Chlorine is the electron hog. It's closer to fluorine. So chlorine, I'm going to fill up until I get 8. Right now, chlorine touches 2 because of the line. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This chlorine is only touching 2. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I've given away 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 electrons. I still have 2 left. Well, the last place for them to go is nitrogen. And that's actually good because now my nitrogen touches 2, 4, 6, 8. And so this right here is my Lewis structure for NCl3. Let's do dinitrogen. So there's 2 nitrogen atoms, which means I have 5 times 2. I have 10 electrons to give away. Arrangement isn't hard. right? I can only put two things in a line. But let's start with single bonds. Two. Let's start by filling them up. So let's pick a nitrogen. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I don't like that very much, right? That is an arrangement that gives away 10 electrons. But do you notice how they're not really well shared? This nitrogen on the left has an octet. 2, 4, 6, 8. But this poor nitrogen on the right is left out in the cold. 1, 2, 3, 4. And so sometimes what we do is we convert lone pairs to bonds, right? To satisfy both octets at once. Sometimes this happens, right? I got myself into a pickle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to erase this lone pair and I'm going to make it a line. So I got rid of two electrons up top and I put them between the nitrogens. This nitrogen still touches 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. So we're getting closer, but this nitrogen still touches 2, 4, 6. We can do a little better. Why don't I do it again? Why don't I erase this one and convert it in? Now, both octets are satisfied. Right? By turning things into double bonds and triple bonds, I can make both things happy at once with not enough electrons to give everybody an octet. 2, 4, 6, 8. And this nitrogen has 2, 4, 6, 8. So this right here is my Lewis structure. And now I like it. We're going to practice some more difficult ones later, but definitely get out your book, try some Lewis structures. It's super, super important that you get these rules down and practice.